The number of Australians partly or totally blind is expected to rise by a staggering 40% over the next decade. And more than half of those are waiting too long to get help, putting themselves at risk.
Beth White can't see a thing, yet she takes her children to school, shops in supermarkets with the help of her daughter, catches the train regularly, steered at all times by her beautiful guide dog Tina. But as an adolescent, when her sight was deteriorating, she resisted support.
And I was not willing to accept what was actually happening to me, and I left it way too late to seek help, and it became potentially dangerous.
Beth says a guide dog rescued her from isolation. She's tried skiing and scuba and says it gave her the confidence to be a mother. Her seven-year-old son Sam now has inherited the same degenerative condition of the retina, and she's ensuring he gets help early from Guide Dogs New South Wales, an organisation aiming to dispel the myth that you need to be completely blind to receive services. They can include canes or devices similar to a car's reversing sensor, which Sam thinks is very useful.
It's a bit hard when you can't see, because when you get close to things, you don't really know whether they're there or not.
We will help them free of charge and get them back on the rails again, get them back mobile and confident again.
Far from denying her condition, Beth and her family is inspiringly positive, thanks to those who give on International Guide Dog Day, coming up next week.
I feel so fortunate to have my independence now. It's enabled me to be able to live a life as I normally would have.
Cheryl Taylor, 10 News.